What's up? I'm Jim Frohn. This is the Ready Check Pull quick preview of Lihuvim, Principal Architect. This fight has an overall design that's a little reminiscent of King Goroth from the Argus Raid in Legion, if you're familiar with that fight. One of the greatest boss fights of all time, by the way. The encounter alternates between a standard boss phase and an ad phase, where you split your raid up to try and kill specific ads before they become active. Basically, when the boss reaches full energy, it goes AFK for a bit and tries to 3D print different types of ads which all have unique abilities. But you have enough time to kill one or two of the ads before they can even spawn. Now, the boss isn't too threatening by itself. It's when the leftover ads have spawned and the boss becomes active again. That's where things get a little sketchy. The main thing the boss does is spawn these motes at several players' locations that don't actually do anything unless you run into them, causing them to turn into permanent pools on the ground. However, you can destroy the motes before they become pools by using the circle debuff that the boss puts out on a couple of players. So you're likely going to end up trying to stack the spawns of the motes so that you can easily clear a bunch of them at the same time. The other big thing the boss does is a damaging pushback on the whole raid. He does this pretty regularly, but as long as you avoid being pushed into the motes, you should be fine. The taunt swap and the frontal are pretty standard, but the animation for the frontal, that's amazing. The fun part is with the ads. Before the boss goes AFK and starts trying to activate the ads, you can actually see ahead of time which type of ads would spawn on each of the four forges. There's four different kinds of ads, and they don't always seem to spawn in the same places. And you can end up with two of the same kind, meaning you're gonna have to plan which ads to kill on the fly. Each ad has a single unique ability. There's one that shields other enemies, there's one that does pulsing damage to the raid, there's one that fixates someone and does a massive knockback whenever it dies, and there's one that's actually a bunch of little ads that channel damage into random players. All pretty simple stuff, but you're gonna end up fighting two or even three of these ads along with the boss when he comes back. And the overlap of all those simple mechanics is where the difficulty of this fight lies. Our official guide for this boss will be out early for our Patreon supporters, so if you're interested in that or you just want to keep us going, check out the links below. Peace.